Hello and greetings from Iceland, but as often before, my plans for today changed due to magnitude 5 earthquake that struck last night here in the north, but it didn't wake me up, even though one picture fell to the floor, since this earthquake could be felt all over North Iceland. But luckily, I'm situated around 100 kilometers south from the epicenter, here in Akureyri, and this is how the town looked before I started editing, as we looked to the north. But let's swap to the map. Here we have the north coast and the Tjörnes fracture zone, or the north part of the plate boundaries through Iceland. And this is where the action is, as we see it on the live feed. And I just made a long video about this area and the magnitude 7 earthquake that might occur there. And it includes some impressive footage of the plate boundaries as they run through a friendly town that might be hit bad. And I'm linking to it since it explains the bigger background picture that you need to know about. But as for the ongoing earthquake swarm, it's to the northwest from the island Grímsey, and luckily, at least so far, it's not shaking the most dangerous part of the fracture zone. This is a well-known earthquake region, and we do get those moments every few years or so. So for the most part, this is nothing new. But there is this trend I want to mention, again, since I've noticed earthquakes recently far out from the north coast, and we don't see them that often, and they are deep down. And when such earthquakes occur, those movements tend to transfer south and lead to increased seismic activity in our fracture zones. And I see this trend also by the south coast, or the south part of the plate boundaries, and I have mentioned this trend in my updates from the Reykjanes Peninsula. So I wasn't surprised when I found out about those earthquakes this morning. I was replying to a comment just yesterday saying that we might be about to get some action up north, judging from those deep earthquakes in the far north. And some of my viewers are obviously noticing this trend as well. But how bad was it last night and what is next? At this moment, the earthquakes are hitting the island Grímsey, a small island on the Arctic Circle, the home of little over 60 people and millions of seabirds. And I'm linking to a video I have about that strange little community that is most likely the hardest place to live in here in Iceland. But it's a 3-hour boat trip. It's also a popular tourist destination. And the biggest question we have now is, will the earthquakes move further south and lead to something more? But I have a feeling that this isn't quite over yet. And when we look at the live view, we can see this huge cluster of earthquakes by the island. But this is a low resolution map. And the map where we can look up earthquakes back in time hasn't been updated, so we can only see the largest earthquakes there, since they only appear after the experts have confirmed the size, depth, and location. So I'm leaving a link to another tool that can be very useful, or a live map with better resolution and zoom-in function. But again, it's not confirmed data, even though it's quite accurate, straight from the extensive network of seismometers up north. And this is how it looks now. And what I notice are those earthquakes that line up to the south since this morning. And they stretch all the way to the worst case scenario, or the part of the Tjörnes fracture zone that we really don't want to give us problems. The most dangerous part of the fracture zone lines up like this, between the island Flatey and the town Húsavík, where we have detected a number of earthquakes today. So my simplified version is that it would not surprise me if this would turn into something more, and mostly due to those deep earthquakes coming from the north into this very sensitive part of the plate boundaries. But please don't get too serious about this though. My channel is not about earthquake predictions or alternative explanations when it comes to geology. Far from it. Like usual, I'm sharing my thoughts. Sometimes I get things right, sometimes not. But as for this location, I just can't ignore this, due to the simple fact that numerous studies have been done around there. And this region, and the town Húsavík especially, is in a way in intensive care by the Civil Protection Agency. The Tjörnes fracture zone is locked and loaded, ready for an earthquake up to magnitude 7. And when it occurs, it's all up to location, how serious things can get. We might get lucky and it would occur far away, causing no harm. But the worst case scenario involves a tsunami, and the part of the plate boundaries that runs straight through this town So it is a simple fact that this is the most dangerous part of the plate boundaries through Iceland when it comes to earthquakes. The tsunami risk comes not just from displacement on the ocean floor. We have some mighty steep mountains all around. So rock slides could also lead to a tsunami, especially in this bay called the Skjálfandaflói. That means the shaking bay. The ocean got sucked out from that bay during an earthquake in the 1800s. And came back in the form of a tsunami, and huge ground displacements can be seen all around. And since this region is locked and loaded, there will be, for the next days, greater risk for large earthquakes than usually. One thing can lead to another. And my questions from my very much limited knowledge in geology are, will those deep earthquakes coming from the far north lead to a long or short chapter of tectonic movements, even migrating onshore, where the plate boundaries run through the Krafla volcano system that erupted 9 times between 1975 and 1984, or where we have seen increased seismic activity lately, but nothing drastic though. And from there, the plate boundaries run through the lake, and from there, the plate boundaries run through the Lake Mývatn region, or one of our most spectacular places to see the plate boundaries due to all the formations that can be found there. And the end station of the north part of the plate boundaries is the Lake Askja volcano, where 35 centimeter land uplift has been detected since August last year, and that's quite a lot, and the story of its own that I have covered in other videos. And overall, I have the feeling that we are about to witness some more action here in the north. It's been almost 50 years since the last big earthquake, or magnitude 6.3 in 1976. The seismic swarms seems to be more frequent now, and I felt quite many earthquakes here in the north where I'm now, or deep in Eyjafjörður, and that's new to us. But Akureyri is, however, not at any serious risk. We are that far away. And in fact, my first earthquake coverage was in 2020, when a big earthquake swarm was plaguing us. But it was a different location back then, further west, on this complicated triangular fracture zone. And now, when I'm finishing this update, this is how the live view looks. And those are not aftershocks fading out, is my guess. And it would not surprise me if there is more energy there to be released. But so far, I've heard very little from our experts, apart from the standard comments like it's the plate boundaries, we do get such earthquakes every now and then, and the statistics and history tell us that this will most likely fade out. But the aftermath from last night's earthquake, the depth, and the earthquakes far north are telling me to be on the lookout. We might get a similar event as in 2020, or weeks of this, and during that period, we are at great risk to be hit with a big one. It will strike sooner or later, but it's way more about that in my full video about this part of the plate boundaries. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the earthquake and the volcano island, Iceland.